everyone, and let's check out another very beautiful, notable chess game from the 19th century. And in this chess game, white is Chigorin, and his opponent is Semion Alapin. And this game was played in 1885, in the late 19th century. So Chigorin, who is playing with the white pieces, starts the game with playing e4, e5, knight to f3, knight to c6, bishop to c4, knight to f6 by Alapin. And Alapin was a strong player. He was a notable chess master for his time. d4 by Chigorin, e takes on d4. Chigorin castled, knight takes on e4. Black is 2 pawns up at this moment of the game. Rook to e1, d5. Bishop takes on d5 by Chigorin, sacrificing the bishop. Queen takes on d5. And can you see the follow-up? Well, Chigorin simply played knight to c3, also sacrificing the knight. But of course, the pawn is pinned, and also the knight is pinned. So the pawn on d4 is relatively pinned. That's why Alapin didn't capture the knight, and he played queen to c4. Well, after knight to c3, if d takes on c3, then queen takes queen, of course. And black is losing. Black needs to resign. So knight to c3 and queen to c4, but rook takes on e4, getting back the material by Chigorin. Bishop to e6, bishop to g5, bishop to c5. If pawn takes knight this time, then this time rook takes queen. If bishop takes rook, queen to e1, bishop to e6, queen takes on c3, and white is winning, obviously. So we have bishop to c5, and knight to d2 by Chigorin, attacking the queen. Queen to a6, knight to b3, defending the bishop, knight to d5. Bishop is pinned, but Alapin castled, and now he is attacking the knight with the bishop. Should Chigorin defend the knight? Well, he didn't want to defend the knight. He threw his knight into the fire. He played knight to f6 by Chigorin. What a move. G takes on f6. And then bishop takes on f6 by Chigorin. Well, in this position, after knight to f6, if let's say king to h8, then rook to h4 is looking extremely unpleasant for black. If bishop to f5, queen to h5, and there is no defense for black. If let's say a random move, then as you can see, black is getting checkmated, and Alapin castled peacefully, and probably he was not expecting knight to f6 move by Chigorin. Knight to f6, g takes on f6, and then bishop takes on f6, as you know. Rook from f to c8, hoping to escape in the future. Queen to h5 by Chigorin. King to f8, escaping. Queen takes on h7, king to e8, but then rook takes on e6 by Mikhail Chigorin, sacrificing the exchange. F takes on e6, capturing the rook. Of course, there is no other defense. Rook to e1 now, and Chigorin is threatening to capture the pawn with the rook. Queen to c4, defending with the queen. Rook to e5 by Chigorin, and Alapin resigned. Black resigned after rook to e5 at move 20. What a game! So maybe at first it may look like this resigning was premature, but actually it was not. So can you see the threat? Let's say a6, a random move. Knight to d2 is deadly for black. So if queen takes on a2, one of the only defense, then b3, queen is not defending the pawn anymore. So queen to a1, knight to f1, queen takes knight, king takes on f1, bishop to c5, rook takes on e6, king to f8, queen to g7, checkmate. So after rook takes on e6, if blocking bit the knight, then simply rook takes knight, bishop takes rook, queen takes on e7, and this is also checkmate. So after rook to e5, the most logical defense was d3, but rook to g5 is deadly, threatening to play rook to g8, only defense with the queen. Rook to g8, queen to f8, queen to g6, king to d7, queen takes on d3, check, queen to d6, rook to g7, how to defend? So let's say knight to e7, but then rook takes knight, king to d8, so after king to d8, rook to h7, that's check with the bishop, discovered check, king to e8, queen to g6, and again, black is getting checkmated. There is no much hope left for Alapin. What a beautiful chess game by Chigorin. So this is why Chigorin captured the bishop with the rook. F takes on e6, rook to e1, and then rook to e5. And this is deadly for black. That's why the Russian player resigned. Alapin resigned. A very beautiful chess game from the late 19th century. A very important and the instructive chess game from the 19th century, a notable chess game. So I hope you have enjoyed watching this video, and I hope to see you next time. Take care and bye-bye.